The Eagle's housing is made of a high-impact polycarbonate polyester blend, which is shielded to reduce radio frequency and electromagnetic interferences, otherwise known as RFI and EMI. The entire instrument is lightweight and balanced, making it easy to carry and use for extended periods of time. Also, a foam rubber gasket seals the top and bottom case components to resist water and dust. All openings on the instrument are sealed, such that the instrument is weather-resistant. However, extra care should be taken to avoid exposing the instrument to rainy conditions for extended periods of time. The control panel is located at the top of the instrument and is made up of 6 large buttons for easy access, even when wearing a pair of gloves. The buttons are touchpad type to reduce the possibility of accidental activation or damage. The liquid crystal display shows 4 lines of information with up to 20 characters per line. The power enter button powers the instrument on or off. The reset silence button is utilized with the various alarms and can either reset or silence an alarm. The display adjust button activates the display modes and enters instructions into the Eagle's microprocessor. The LEL PPM button changes the detection for the combustible gas channel between the percent of the lower explosive limit, or percent LEL, and the parts per million, or PPM ranges. The LEL range is most commonly used in safety type applications where flammability may be an issue, and the PPM range is typically used in environmental or other special applications. The air up button activates the Eagle's demand zero function, which automatically adjusts the instrument to a fresh air condition. The shift down button is not used for general operation of the instrument. 2 bright red LEDs provide a visual alarm for gas concentrations and malfunctions. They are both located on the top rear of the Eagle's case for optimum visibility. The battery charger connector is mounted on the top right rear of the instrument. An external RKI battery charger can be connected here to recharge the NiCad type batteries, which should operate the instrument for up to 18 hours between charges. The interface port is mounted on the top left rear of the case. This port can connect to optional remote type alarms such as a remote buzzer or strobe light. A solid-state electronic buzzer is mounted inside the top of the case just under the handle. The buzzer will sound in the event of a gas alarm, a malfunction, low battery voltage, or is an indicator that a button has been pressed. The Eagle sample drawing system is designed to provide a continuous flow of sampled air to the sensors for long periods of time while keeping out liquids and dust. With proper setup, this system can draw a sample from up to 125 feet away from the Eagle at a rate of 1 second per foot. The standard 4-gas Eagle is equipped with 4 sensors to monitor combustibles, oxygen, carbon monoxide, and hydrogen sulfide. These standard sensors have an operating life of approximately 2 years. Other sensor information can be found under non-standard toxic sensors, carbon dioxide sensors, and infrared methane sensors. The combustible sensor is mounted with a flame arrestor down in the sensor block to allow the sample flow to diffuse into the sensor. The sensor cable connects to the pins on one end and terminates in a 4-position connector, which plugs into the COMB, or combustible socket, on the analog print circuit board. The oxygen sensor is mounted face down in the sensor block to allow the sample flow to diffuse into the sensor. A multi-pin plug connects the oxygen sensor into the CN2 socket on the analog PCB. The carbon monoxide and hydrogen sulfide sensors are physically very similar. They both have cylindrical bodies and are mounted face down in the sensor block. A 3-position connector from each sensor plugs into EC1 or EC2 sockets on the analog PCB. The sensor connected to the EC1 socket displays as channel 3, and the sensor connected to the EC2 socket displays as channel 4. The Eagle circuit boards analyze, record, control, store, and display the information collected by monitoring with the Eagle. The analog PCB provides the support circuitry for the Eagle sensors. It is located perpendicular to the base of the instrument case. It is located in the same half of the case as the sensors and sample drawing system. Here you can see how the sensor leads connect to the analog PCB. The main PCB is the microprocessor that controls the instrument and includes the methane elimination switch and calibration setup switches. The main PCB is mounted in the top half of the case. Only fully authorized repair personnel who have certified training should service any of the EEL circuit boards. For applications where methane is interfering gas, you can set the methane elimination switch to eliminate most responses to methane. More detailed information can be found in the methane elimination section. The methane elimination switch is labeled as SW1 and is mounted near the top right corner of the main PCB. For frequent use of this switch, an external methane elimination switch is available as an option. As a security feature, the EEL is equipped with an adjustment lockout switch, also known as the Cal setup switch. This switch can be set to prevent users from having access to the calibration and setup menus of the EEL. The adjustment lockout switch is mounted near the middle left edge of the main PCB and is labeled SW2.